It's a competitive time. You've gone through a lot of hoops. You've jumped through some hoops to either save up money for your down payment. In some cases, you've sold your home in order to come up with a down payment. You've beat out multiple offers. You've negotiated. You've won. You've got your home, only to later regret it. I don't want you to feel that, and I'm going to share with you my 5 tips on how to avoid regret when buying a home. Tip number 1. Don't compromise on your non-negotiables. Prioritize your non-negotiables and don't compromise on them. What do I mean by that? You know, they're most likely, as you're going through your home buying journey, you're going to develop a list. You're going to have your needs and you're going to have your wants. And a need might be, you know, you need to live within a certain school district, right? You need your kids to go to school at that certain place. Or you need a certain bedroom count in order to, you know, maintain the lifestyle that you want. You need a certain amount of bathrooms, right? There's no way your family of 6 is going to move into a 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom home. It's just not going to happen. And so those are your needs. While your wants might be, you know, you want an updated kitchen, you want a pool, you want a certain type of floor plan. Those are wants. I can't tell you how many times I've had serious conversations with home buyers that are inside a home. They love it. It has an updated kitchen. It has beautiful flooring. You know, it's got a pool. It's got all of these great amenities that come with the home, but it doesn't have all of their needs. They're compromising on a bedroom because of the way that the home looks, and they love it. They're compromising on, you know, maybe that 3rd bathroom that in the beginning they said was a need, and now they're like, oh, maybe not. Don't compromise on your need just to satisfy a want. You can get wants later. Most of the time you can update a kitchen. Most of the time you can add a pool. Most of the time you can make changes to your wants, or you can compromise on your want because at least you have the need. You have your non-negotiables and you've acquired them, and you won't regret it later. Number 2, set your budget and stick to it. Now, I highly advise you dive deep with your mortgage broker prior to shopping for a home, and don't just talk about what are my qualifications under, you know, this amount of down payment and this mortgage amount that I want. Talk about what are my qualifications if I have to, get flexible, if I have to get creative, if I have to maybe add some additional cash towards the purchase price in the event of a low appraisal, or if I have to, you know, stretch my budget a little bit, how can I restructure that in my down payment so that I can keep, you know, my mortgage at a place that I'm comfortable with. Dive deep with your mortgage broker into different scenarios and understand ahead of time what your true range of purchase power is prior to going out and searching for a home, where you might run into some tension and start feeling a little bit of buyer's remorse or regret is if you don't know those numbers right away. You find a home that you love it, you absolutely love it, you want it, you overextend yourself to get it, and then you find out later from your mortgage broker the reality of that decision isn't something that you're comfortable with, then you'll feel regret. Know ahead of time your numbers, and not just the one number, know a couple of ranges of options, and then you can make a good decision going forward. This is a fun one, and I often joke with my clients. So number three tip is stop looking at homes once you're in contract on a home, and definitely stop looking at homes once you've bought one. You know, you can't play the what if game. If you've committed to a home that fits your needs, that fits your criteria, and you love it, you love the home, stop looking at other ones. There's nothing good that can come from that, aside from maybe if you're looking for decoration ideas, I get it, that's fine. But turn off your alerts. You don't need to be notified every time a new listing hits the market. Who knows how that would have panned out anyhow? You don't want to live in that space. You want to be happy, you want to be excited, you want to start, you know, pouring the love into your existing home. So turn off the notifications. You know, if you were married, you probably would unsubscribe from Match.com or Tinder or whatever dating website you're on. Same thing with a house. You've committed to buying this house. It's your home. Start making it a home and stop looking at the next best thing. Number four, trust your gut and your agent. Sometimes you just gotta go with your gut. If it checks all the boxes, you know, but it just doesn't feel right, listen to yourself. It's a fast-paced market. It's a wild time. But, you know, trusting your gut, listening to your agent who you've shared your stories with, you've shared your goals with, who knows what, you know, your real estate goals are, they're going to know if it's maybe not the right fit for you. All right? So trust your gut. Don't be afraid to slow down a little bit, even in this fast-paced market, and listen to yourself and your agent. And the number five tip, which is critical, I kind of left it towards the end because it's almost a no-brainer. You have to make sure that you're securing your peace of mind and doing your due diligence when purchasing a home. Do your inspections. Follow the advice of your real estate agent. Follow the advice of your home inspector if they recommend additional inspections. Do your due diligence. Even in this wild seller's market, maybe you've even waived your inspection contingency, still do your due diligence. Because I don't know about you, but I'd rather walk away from an earnest money deposit if I've waived. Let's say the scenario is I've waived all of my contingencies, which is wild, but is happening right now in this market. I would still rather do my due diligence and walk away from my $5,000-$10,000 earnest money deposit than purchase a $500,000 or $1 million home if there's a $20,000-$50,000 issue that maybe I wasn't aware of. So even if you've waived your contingencies away, still do your due diligence, because that's the surefire way to secure your peace of mind. You'll be happy. You'll know that you purchased a sound home, and you won't have any regret. So those are my top five tips for how to avoid regret when purchasing a home. If you have any additional questions, please let me know, and I encourage you to go through our website and check out some of our other blog posts. We post videos and blog content weekly, and we're happy to be a resource for you in your home buying or home selling journey. Thanks for watching. I'm Jeff Goolsbee with the Goolsbee Group, and I'm here to help you win at real estate.